Yes, I don't think I missed anything.
No, we paused. All right, we're moving on now to Dave's final revised district budget.
So we'll be going over the expenditures for the general fund on our final presentation of the budget, revenues from the general fund, other funds, and then the use of reserve fund balance for the 4K program. So what we're doing here is a comparison, and what we'll have is a vote on the final budget now that we've set the tax levy. And that is a main piece of, you know, the revenues coming in, so that helps us decide how to set the rest of the budget. Our budget for 16-17 is in the first column. And then what our actuals were for that year, last school year, our original budget that we approved at the annual meeting, our final budget that I'm recommending approval for tonight, and some of the changes. So when we look at the salaries, back in 16-17 last school year, we had about $34.4 million set aside, and we spent about $1 million less. So looking at that budget, looking at the final budget for 17-18 that I'm recommending, a $33,876,000 budget for salaries. That includes CPI, consumer price index increases, and moves within different pieces of salaries frameworks. The benefits include the health insurance, which we have an increase of 8.5% in the second half of the year, so that'll happen in January. Also with the CPI, when there's salary increases, that also increases your FICA tax and your Wisconsin retirement contribution, and so that relates to those areas. Fringe benefits, we were at 13 million. We're still around 13 million, so not a major increase in that area. The purchase services, so this is when we're purchasing services from others, also utilities or maintenance and repairs, you know, when we're contracting with somebody that's not an employee. Utilities is a big part of that. So about 11 million, almost 11 and a half million dollars for this budget. No major increases in those areas. Non-capital is just the general supplies and operational kind of supplies, anything under $5,000. Most of that relates to increases in our 4K and our Title I, some additional spending in those areas for supplies, textbooks, and so on. So $2.5 million in that area. Capital are items over $5,000. Pretty steady that way compared to actual last year. And then 700, 800, 900 objects are for insurances, and then also 800 is transferred to different projects, other funds, 900s are dues and fees. What we've determined, or what I'm recommending with this budget, we set aside $250,000 going to Fund 46 for the Jackson Fund. When I've completed this budget, we had some more revenue than expenses, and at this point, I'm recommending that we include that and increase that $250,000 to $1,035,000. So we had extra when we're crunching the numbers, but also realizing that I wouldn't want to make that transfer till later on in the school year, because as Tiffany said, I'm crunching numbers here, but I'm only 2 months into it, and a lot of times I'm opening the door and I'm seeing a new contract and saying, okay, did I budget for that? Didn't I budget for that? So knowing that we have this, we have the potential of adding that to the Jackson Fund, but also I want the board to have that understanding that we look at it at the end of the year and say, okay, how's everything else going? And we're gonna look at our budgets on a constant basis where we are expending versus projections of forecasting the rest of the year. So right now, let's budget that in there. So comparing it to last year's budget, it's a small increase. So small, when we look at the overall numbers, we're looking at about a, compared to the expenditures last year, it's a larger increase, but comparing it to the budget the previous year, we're going from 70,091,000 to 70,514,000. When we look at any questions on expenditures, before I move to the money coming in instead of going out.
Well, it's not a question as much as just a general observation. With 46, I think it's great that we've already set aside 250,000 for Jackson for the year, right?
Right.
So I think the other consideration is just considering the values, the priorities. I, as a parent, I get emails all the time as fundraisers for different clubs and athletics and programs that are really stretched to a degree. So I think it would be nice to consider if near the end of the year we have a little extra, how else do we allocate it to our current day students as a possibility too. So I just ask the board to kind of consider that as well. I know Ken mentioned how many different fundraisers currently ongoing, even at Decorah. And there's a responsibility I think we have to serving our constituents today as much as we have to in the future.
I realize I wasn't at the work session, so right. Sorry if you went over this already. I guess when you say later in the year to dedicate the funds to the Jackson Project Fund 46, how much later are we talking about? I would just hate to bite our nose off to spite our face here. I mean, $1 million is a, you know, much greater sum than what we're typically dedicating towards that. I mean, so $1 million is giving me a little bit of heart palpitations because that's a big jump. So, I mean, I wonder, is $500,000 a more, you know, easily digested number for me personally, because that seems like it's $250,000 more, so we're doubling, but then we're leaving ourselves some cushions in the event that something doesn't go exactly as planned. I would just hate to dedicate something only to find out, hey, we've got some other things that we needed to take care of, or we've got some other changes. I know we're about to hear about the compensation plan this evening and how that could greatly affect probably our budget. So that would just be a caution and a concern that I have as a board member.
I would maybe just add a further comment with the recommendation from Mr. Vince Bankering. I think that is a good one at this time. And as David said, that typically June, all the financial results start to catch up with year end. And what should happen every year would be a final motion by the board upon recommendation of the business office as to how much to transfer to 46. So for sure, that's a good concern. And if in the meantime we have something happen where we don't have $1,035,000 or whatever the number is, of course we can adjust at that time, and then the recommendation from the business office will be subsequently smaller.
If I may, I'd like to see that number kept there as a target. We are looking at a building project in Jackson that is on the drawing board, so we know that is more than likely going to happen. And I really would like us to put as much into that trust fund as possible to reduce the tax burden that will be coming along to the our future generations, as well as the people on fixed incomes and so on. And there are also young families too who are going to be faced with increased taxes too for that funding that referendum. I'm not saying it's not worthwhile, but I think we need to think about that too.
On the revenue side, so we have our local revenues, which are, the majority of that comes from the property tax levy, that you just certified. Other things in there might be